And continuing through this debugger statement, we should have a map drawn on our page. As you can see here, we have a map of the world. And while there's a few quirks, in this case, Greenland and the top of the northern hemisphere is slightly cut off, and Antarctica is huge, we've drawn an SVG map of all the countries in the world with just a few lines of D3 and JavaScript. This is quite an accomplishment. To better position our map, we can use this scale and translate functions on the projection. These both allow us to move and manipulate the visual display of the map. Think of scale as similar to the plus and minus zoom buttons on something like Google Maps, and translate as dragging the center of the map to a different location. In our case, we're setting the scale to be 170, and we're translating the center of our map to be half the width and half the height of our SVG element already on the page. I encourage you to play around with the values of scale and translate to really understand how they affect the visual map that a reader looks at. If we then reload the page, we can see here that our map has been centered and it's been zoomed out slightly so that we can see all of the northern hemisphere and still all of Antarctica. For the rest of this lesson, I'm going to translate the map down so that Antarctica gets cut off since it's not in any World Cup games, and the important parts of the map for us, in this case, the participating countries in the World Cup, will be a bit larger and easy to see. And the last change to make the map slightly more readable and a little bit more aesthetically pleasing is to change the fill of the countries from black to Udacity blue, in this case, to change the outline of each country border to a darker black line, and to make the stroke width slightly thinner so we can see more detail in the borders of countries. Going back to the map, we can see here that all the countries are filled in with blue, and the black stroke that's slightly thinner makes it much easier to see the different countries on the map.